Hi, good morning. Welcome to the morning prayer meeting. And if you have the Bible, look at 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1 to 7. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1 to 7. Now, for the matters you write about, it is good for a man not to marry. But since there is so much immorality, each man should have his own wife, and each woman her own husband. The husband should fulfill his material duty to his wife, and likewise the wife to her husband. The wife's body does not belong to her alone, but also to her husband. In the same way, the husband's body does not belong to him alone, but also to his wife. Do not deprive each other, except by mutual consent and for a time, so that you may devote yourself to prayer. Then come together again, so that Satan will not tempt you because of your lack of self-control. And I say this as a concession, not as a command. I wish that all men were as I am, but each man has his own gift from God. One has this gift, another has that. This morning, I would like to share with you, understand the marriage. And then you have to understand the marriage life. If you are single, and then, yeah, if you have the single gift, you don't need to marry. You know, verse 1, it is good for a man not to marry. What Paul say? It's good for a man not to marry. But in the book of Genesis chapter 2 verse 18 say, this is what God say, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him, which means a wife. What is a first organization in the world after creation? Family. Family is the first organization before the church, before any other organization. Family is very, very important, but Satan tried to destroy the family. But Paul says it is good for a man not to marry. But the Bible, Almighty God say in the book of Genesis, say it is not good for the man to be alone. And then God said, I will make a helper suitable for him. And God made Adam and Eve. Do you know why Paul, he said that it is good for man not to marry? Why he say that? Because, of course, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, he continue to explain. If you married a man and married a woman, you try to please your husband, your wife. And then Paul say, instead of you try to please your husband, your wife, why not pleasing God alone if you are single? But that is optional. If you have a single gift, if you have a single gift, you can be a single. What does mean single gift? If you don't have any lust, if you look at the verse 2, you know, Paul explained, but since there is so much immorality, if you have some immoral, like sexually, some desire, yeah, get married. Each man should have his own wife. Each woman, she can get her own husband. This is what the Bible says. Yeah? And then Paul, that is why if you are single, yeah, if you're single, but you have a sexually immoral in your heart, you have some lust, yeah. If you have that kind of lust, get married. Good for you. Good for you. And then if you have own your wife and own your husband, and how wonderful. Do you know, as I'm a missionary in UK, I counseling for many young brothers and sisters in UK, British people. They are, you know, early 20s, or, you know, even teenage boys and girls. They are so struggled because of the sexually, they have, lust. When they have lust, it's so difficult. And they counseling with me. I say to them, okay, let's pray together. They don't have the single gift at all. Get married. That is why, verse 3, the husband should fulfill his material duty. What does mean material duty means? You know, if a wife want to get sex with her husband, the husband need to submit to his wife. And the same thing, wife submitted to husband. It's very, very important. This is the word of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 3, the husband should fulfill his material duty to his wife, and likewise the wife to her husband. You see, they submit to each other. And then Paul, he actually, verse 4, he knew about the marriage very well. You know, many theologians say the Apostle Paul, he was a married man. But when he was a married man, then he become born again, and his wife died because people, they kill his wife. And then this man, he understand the marriage life very well. If he never married, he never understand the marriage life. Therefore, he understood it very well. And verse 4, he said that the wife's body belonged to husband. Do you understand? Wife's body belonged to husband. Therefore, husband want to sex is his wife. My wife cannot say, no, I don't want. That is wrong. Wife's body belonged to husband. Husband's body belonged to wife. This is what the Bible says. Yeah? Therefore, don't separate. Verse 5, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 5, only for a while, for a time, so that you may devote yourself to prayer. You can be separate, only exception, only for time of prayer. But otherwise, you have to gain a meeting again, live together again. Verse 5 is saying, do you know what the Bible say? And then, you know, for a you can separate for a time, so that you may devote yourself to prayer. Then come together again. Then come together again. Do you know, that is totally wrong. Somebody, husband, wife, you know, not live together for a long time. I strongly against it. This is not will of the law. The will of God for you and me is your husband and wife live together in harmony and unity. This is what the Bible say. And then, you know, then come together when you separate because of prayer. You know, because of prayer, you can separate for a while. But then come together again. And Satan will not tempt you because of your lack of self-control. Yeah? If you have lack of self-control, if you cannot control your sexual desire, what's going to happen? Satan did not attack you. Therefore, we have to, you know, remember if your husband and wife live together in same room, same house. I know some couples, even pastors, they don't live together. They live in same house, but they don't sleep together. Husband and wife sleep a different room. That is totally, totally wrong in the eyes of God. Why? Because of what the Bible says. So that Satan will not tempt you because of your lack of self-control. You know, marriage man, marriage woman, if they don't live together in same room, is a Satan attack easily. Therefore, please remember that this is the word of God. And Paul, he understands the human's body. He say, please, you need to understand the marriage life. You know, if your husband, wife, please live together. Live together. And then only for a time you can separate for prayer. Otherwise, don't separate. Do you know, plan of Satan, steal, kill, destroy. John chapter 10, verse 10. Satan tried to destroy the family. You know, I was working in the bricks and prison for 20 years. Do you know, these prisoners coming from the 70% of a broken family. The background of a prisoners, 70% of the, you know, prisoners come from the broken family, divorce or separate, and this kind of family. Therefore, do you know, if a husband, wife, and mommy and daddy divorce, automatically many their children easily to divorce and separate. Therefore, my prayer for my Christian brothers, sisters, if you're a married man, if you're a single man and woman, please pray to God for your future. Pray for your marriage. Pray for your future husband, future wife. Pray for your husband, your wife. And many prayer, you know, requests. Pastor Paul, can you pray for my husband to start a new life? Somebody asked me, Pastor Paul, can you pray for my wife to start a new life? They asked me to change their husband, their mom, their wife. But I have good news for you. Before you want to see the transformation, your husband, your wife, you yourself surrender your life to Jesus. You yourself repent of the sins. You can start a new life in Christ Jesus. If you start a new life in Christ Jesus, God will deal with your husband and your wife. He can change your husband. I know one lady in America is the most famous writer about marriage and family. She prayed to God for her husband to start a new life. She prayed to God for her husband for 30 years. Lord, oh God, would you change my husband? Prayed and prayed, day and night. But God never hear her prayer. And she changed her mind. She prayed to God, Lord, change me. Change me. And when God heard her prayer, change me, God changed her, and automatically her husband changed. Do you understand what this meaning? We need to pray to God, Lord, instead of you asking God, Lord, change my husband, change my wife, ask God, Lord, change me. I'm a sinner. Oh, Lord, have mercy on me. Forgive my sins. Would you transform my life? He will do it. God will do it. God will answer you. Yeah, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 6, this is not commandment, yeah, but a concession. It's like a suggestion, advice, what Paul say. But, you know, when Paul advised, this is the will of God in heaven. And then look at the verse 7, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 7, I wish that all men were as I am. But each man has his own gift from God. And one has this gift, another has that. Do you know, as I told you earlier, single gift. I know one guy, when he look at the beautiful woman, he never attractive. He's just, and I told him, you have a single gift. And he said, what is a single gift? I told him very clearly, you're a man, if you look at a beautiful woman, yeah, it's nothing happen inside him, your heart. I think there's a single gift. He has single any lust in his heart. I think this kind of people, they can be a single all the days of their life. But I heard about the John Stott. Do you know John Stott? He's a wonderful theologian. He died a few years ago. He's an amazing English theologian and writer. Basic Christianity is a wonderful book. And John Stott, he never married. And then I met John Stott's friend. Why he never married? And John Stott, he still has got some desire to marry the one woman. But his friend married the lady, and then he gave up, and he lived as a single. I understand that. But if you have some rust inside your heart, the Bible says if you have the immoral, if you have so much immorality in your heart, get married. If you have your lust is burning in your heart, get married. Good for you. In our church, young brothers and sisters, I pray for my brothers and sisters, oh God, helping them to find out the best woman, best man. The man come from mighty God, who is filled with the power of the Holy Spirit and who fear God. You know, best man, best woman. Who is the best man, best woman in the eyes of the Lord? Who fear God. Who fear God, who humble themselves before God and filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. These people are best woman, best man for their future partner. Therefore, if you have a single gift, live as a single. Yeah. Therefore, Paul said, all men were as I am. You know, he wishes everybody live like me. I'm single now, and Paul encouraged. But he said, each man has his own gift from God. If you have your gift to get married, please get married. But pray to God. On 17th of July, which is around 2 weeks' time, I will conduct the wedding ceremony. I prophesied for one brother, his brother Sean. I told him, I think very soon you'll get married, and if you get married, I can conduct it for your wedding ceremony. I spoke to him last year, but now this year, in year 2021, he get married. A wonderful woman, Sister Kim, and then will be wife. I'm so happy because I was praying for Brother Sean, and I don't know who was his wife, but now he found. Do you know, therefore, when you live in this world, if you understand the marriage, it's very, very important. I'm going to have a Bible study with Brother Sean and Sister Kim before they have a wedding ceremony. It's good to understand, good to know before you marriage. You know, if you're a single man and single woman, prepare for marriage. But if you're already husband and wife, you can study continually how to support for your husband, how to support for your wife. Respect one another. If you're a married man and you're a single man and woman, I want to share three things. I think every day is a family, three things. Number one, forgive one another. Number two, love one another. Number three, keep patient. You know, patience is very, very important in the family. If you don't have a patience, it's easily the family, you know, fighting one another, quarrel one another. It's terrible if you don't have a patience. Forgive, love, and patience. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for this opportunity. I pray for family. When God made Adam and Eve, this is the first organization in the eyes of the Lord, family, husband and wife, and then children coming. And Father, my prayer, dear Heavenly Father, people, they committed a sin sexually. Therefore, family destroyed and ruined. But my prayer, let husband and wife understand the scripture. And then they love one another, they respect one another, they forgive one another, they keep patient for each other. Especially the Bible say, Lord Jesus say, I'm holy, you should be holy. Father, help us to be a holy life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Have a wonderful morning and now. And in UK, in morning, 6 o'clock in the morning. In Korea now, 2 o'clock, I think 2:15 in the afternoon. Have a wonderful evening and then morning. God bless you. Bye now.